Are generic medications just as good as the brand? I'm going to talk about why you may notice a difference when you take certain generic medications. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I publish weekly videos on mental health education and self-improvement. So if you don't want to miss one, click subscribe and notifications. So to cut to the chase, in theory, yes, generic medications are just as good when it comes to clinical effect and safety. But for some medications, you can see differences in how they work for you. And I've seen this variability most with bupropion, which has the brand name Wellbutrin, and that's what I'm going to use as an example in this video. When a new drug comes to market, the FDA gives the drug company exclusive rights to produce and market the drug until their patent runs out. GlaxoSmithKline lost their patent protection for Wellbutrin in 2006, paving the way for other companies to come in and make bupropion. In order to do this, the new company has to show the FDA that their version of the drug is bioequivalent to the original Wellbutrin. What does it mean to be bioequivalent? There's a very complex definition of that on the Code of Federal Regulations website, and I have a link to that in the description if you want to read through it and have fun with that. Here's a very simplified definition. According to the FDA, a generic drug is bioequivalent if there's no significant difference in the way that the active ingredient of the drug becomes available in your body if you take it at the same dose as the original. There's a couple of key words here that get to the heart of how generic medications can work differently. The first is no significant difference. This is not saying that the drugs have to be identical. They just can't be significantly different. So what's considered a significant difference? A significant difference is defined by bioequivalence limits, which the FDA sets as 80% to 125%. These percentages refer to the range of the peak concentrations of the drug and how much of it is absorbed over time. For you science enthusiasts, that would be the area under the curve. So let me show you what I mean. This is what a drug activity curve looks like. You take the medication, it's digested and goes into your bloodstream. Then it goes to the part of the body that it's supposed to be used for, in this case, our brain. So looking at this curve, after the drug gets into your bloodstream, it reaches a maximum concentration in your blood. Then, as the drug is metabolized and broken down, the levels drop. With bioequivalence, let's say Wellbutrin reached a concentration of 100 in 5 hours, then drifts down to a really low levels in 24 hours. This section here is how much stays in your body and for how long. The generic can come along and reach a peak that's 25% higher than Wellbutrin or 20% lower. How long it takes to get to this maximum can also fall in this window. Do these differences matter? Maybe. It depends on your sensitivity to the drug. It could be that this is just what you need to have enough in your system, but then the next time the pharmacy uses a different manufacturer and your curve looks like this. This lower concentration may be just enough difference to change how it affects you. Alternatively, the next month, you get another manufacturer, and your curve looks like this. This higher spike may give you more side effects. Okay, so maybe you aren't that sensitive to that 20% difference in concentration and absorption. Here's the main reason, though, that I think you could see a difference in the generics. The rule of bioequivalence refers to the active ingredients. Bupropion is the active ingredient, but with all medications, there's lots of inactive ingredients, and they're called excipients. These inactive ingredients are things like fillers to bulk up the medication, coatings, flavorings, disintegrants, which are the agents that help dissolve it. Another active ingredient is called a vehicle. The vehicle is the substance that's used to get it down. So an example of this would be the liquid form of a medication. A common liquid used is mineral oil. So different manufacturers can use different agents to produce the drug. And those different agents can make a difference in the side effects that you experience and how it's absorbed in your body. So does this mean your generics aren't as good? No, it doesn't. For many drugs, there just isn't much difference between the brand and the generic. So you don't want to just insist on brand for every medication just because you think that it's going to be, or that it's not as good. And this goes for over-the-counter medications as well, because you can end up spending a lot of money unnecessarily. But if you've been taking a medication for a while and you notice that you don't feel the same on it, or you have new side effects, check to see if the pills look different, or if you have a different manufacturer than you had before. You can usually see what company made the drug if you look on the label. It's typically at the bottom of the bottle, and it'll say MFG. Sometimes you can request a certain manufacturer, you can still get the generic price. But sometimes the only way to control for side effects or effectiveness is to request the brand only. And some insurances will pay for the brand, but just make your copayment higher. Last tip, there's an online site called GoodRx, and they have an app if you prefer using an app. On this site, you can get coupons for discounted medication, and you don't even need to register with the site. It's also good for seeing how much medications cost at different pharmacies. You can enter your zip code and the medication and then see how much the price is from pharmacy to pharmacy. So it's good for checking on prices even if you don't want to use the coupon. Share this video with someone who you think could use it and like the video if you like it. Thanks for watching. See you next time.